Now, your First Alert weather with meteorologist Michael Coates.
Well, folks in Rexburg, don't need me to tell you that you got a nasty storm moving through right now. You can hear it out there. You can see the trees blowing in sideways. Look at that, the camera pushing. Well, you can see here on the First Alert Live Skycam, the wind pushing those trees coming out of the west and the southwest. We've even seen a few lightning strikes. Camera right now is getting pummeled. The camera's on top of the water tower, just to give you an idea. And I pointed it back into Rexburg proper. So BYU Idaho and downtown is right there, but you can't really see much now because it's all shrouded in rain and cloud cover. And that's all moving into Rexburg as we speak. A wide view of Viper radar. We've had passing showers and thunderstorms throughout the afternoon, stretching in there from central Idaho. We've been seeing some showers in areas of Custer and Lemhi County. Showers also in Yellowstone and Grand Teton National Parks this afternoon. But some good thunderstorms have been making their way through areas of the Snake River Plain this afternoon. And we have more thunderstorms out to the west of us trying to get in here for tonight and tomorrow morning. A little bit of a closer view right now. Here's that thunderstorm band that's currently making its way into the upper valley, leaving Idaho Falls with some lighter showers at the moment. But this thunderstorm is getting right over Rexburg, and it's going to be traveling north shortly here into Sugar and St. Anthony and Fremont County. And then we also have the same band stretching all the way along I-15 into Dubois and up down to Spencer. And you can see this is all moving towards Island Park and Ashton. So this thing looks like it's going to be a pretty mean sell as it continues its path through Fremont County. It's also going to skirt through a bit of Teton County here shortly. The tail end of this band is actually now just starting to get out towards Antelope Flats in the High C area. And then it's going to try to spill a little bit over into Swan Valley and Irwin as we speak. So this thing is a band stretching from about Lima, Montana, all the way down here into the mountains out towards Bone. So here we go. Got that thunderstorm at least with us for another hour or so, moving to the northeast at a pretty good pace. Pocatello in the clear for the moment. We're starting to get a little wet weather there coming into areas of just outside of the Gate City. Some spotty sprinkles there in the mountains west of Pocatello, but more thunderstorms trying to build in here out of the Magic Valley. So we're not done yet. We're still going to have some storms passing through the region tonight, and even after sunset, we're going to have some late night thunderstorms all coming off this area of low pressure, which is currently making its way overhead for tonight and tomorrow. But by Wednesday, most of that wet weather is going to be pushed to the north of us in towards Montana. So the lows coming in tonight, dropping our temperatures, dropping in the cooler wind with the jet stream going to our south. And then we're going to move that wet weather to the north of us as we head into Wednesday and Thursday. Here's the Viper cast showing us the thunderstorms later tonight, about 10 o'clock overnight. And then everybody's asking about the lunar eclipse. Unfortunately, we have cloud cover in the forecast, and we're going to try to get a little bit of some clearing sky early tomorrow morning. And we might get lucky here from Pocatello to Idaho Falls, as you can see on the Vipercast. But we're going to be fighting that cloud cover early tomorrow morning. And again, the best time to see the lunar eclipse will be early 5 a.m., about 5 a.m. to about 5:15. In fact, 5:11 is actually when it's expected to peak in our time zone. But we will be seeing more of these passing thunderstorms trying to rebuild back in here for Wednesday afternoon. Gusty winds off of those cells, but yeah, it's going to be a windy, colder day for Wednesday. The sun comes out for Thursday. Things are looking nicer for Thursday at least. Here's a look at the wind map tonight. These aren't really accounting for the thunderstorm gusts, so we'll have gusty conditions from the thunderstorms. But the winds tomorrow, all day long for Wednesday, into the teens and 20s out of the west and the southwest, with your gusts approaching 30, 40 miles an hour. And of course, the thunderstorms will play havoc with those wind gusts. 64 for McCam tomorrow, 60 in Lava Hot Springs with a high of 68 in Malad. We've got highs at 56 tomorrow in Jackson, 62 for Rexburg, 61 in St. Anthony with highs in central Idaho, 59 for Mackey, 64 in Chalice, 65 in Arco. And Idaho Falls should see a high of 64 tomorrow with 65 in Pocatello and 67 in Burley. Extended forecasts will have temperatures in, again, colder tomorrow, 63 for the expected high in Idaho Falls, warming to the 70s for Thursday. And things are looking windy this Memorial Day weekend with a slight chance of a thunder shower on Saturday. And then highs for Monday should be pushing closer to 80 degrees for your Memorial Day holiday. Pocatello 65, gusty winds dropping temperatures for tomorrow, looking nicer for Thursday. Windy conditions in there for Friday and Saturday with a slight chance of a storm cloud coming through this weekend. Blackfoot, you'll see a high here of 65 for Wednesday, 73 for Thursday, 70 on Friday. Now, most of the storm clouds this weekend are going to be into the mountains. So if you're going to Island Park this weekend, you're going into Driggs, if you're going into Yellowstone, you do have a chance for seeing some clouds this weekend and a chance of showers. But the Snake River Plain, as you take a look at the Rexburg 8-day forecast at this point, just a slight chance of a storm storm cloud this Saturday afternoon with high in the upper 60s. We're back into the mid-70s by Sunday and mid-70s there for Monday. But stormy conditions again for tonight and tomorrow with temperatures into the 50s and 60s. Quite a bit of wet weather still in central Idaho here for Wednesday with highs around 62 for tomorrow, 75 for Thursday, and 65 as we get into Friday. Jackson, you have highs here into the mid-50s. A good amount of wet weather still with you there in western Wyoming and far eastern Idaho for tomorrow. And then we'll have a few spotty thunderstorms in the forecast for Memorial Day weekend with highs into the 60s. Our John Adams GMC Spirit of Idaho comes to us from Tina and Pocatello, and I picked this picture just to remind you that fishing in Idaho is an extreme sport. I know they have the X Games, but this is Idaho's extreme sport, fishing in snow.
Sponsored by Red Bull.
Sponsored by Red Bull.
When he started, it was sunny.
That's true.
Yeah.
And when he's done, it'll probably be sunny.
Exactly.
Especially this time of year, right?
That's dedication. That's great.
Hopefully you caught a lot. So.
I hope it was worth it. Extreme sports. So with sports in mind, thanks, Michael. Dylan, you've got some good football news if you're a fan.
Yeah.